Greetings, XCeL, and welcome again. This is the day that the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it.
And we have our praise and worship song led today by Miss Brianna.
Bible declares that man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word that proceedeth out of the mouth of God. Let's listen for some encouraging words from the Bible from our young people of XCeL.
121 verse 1 and 2. I will lift my eyes unto the hills, from whence comes my help. My help comes from the Lord, who made heaven and earth.
God is in your midst, a mighty one who will save. He will rejoice over you with gladness.
He will quiet you by his love. He will exalt over you with his loud singing. Zephaniah 3:17.
Through the tender mercy of our God, whereby the day spring from on high has visited us to give light to them that sit in darkness and the shadow of death, to guide our feet into the way of peace. Luke chapter 1, verse 78-79.
Good news is, even in the dark times, even when death draws near, the mercy of God is always available to comfort us and grant us peace.
Isaiah 26:3. You will keep him in perfect peace, whose mind is stayed on you, because he trusts in you. Colossians 3:15. And let the peace of Christ rule in your hearts, to which indeed you are called in one body, and be thankful.
2 Corinthians 4:16-18 says, therefore we do not lose our heart. Even though our outward man is perishing, our inward man is being renewed day by day. For our light affliction, which is but just a moment, is working for us far more exceeding and eternal weight of glory. We do not look at things that are seen, but instead look at things which are not seen. For things that are seen are temporary, and things which are not seen are eternal.
Matthew 6:34. Therefore, do not be anxious about tomorrow, but tomorrow will be anxious for itself. Sufficient for the day is its own trouble.
John 14:27. Peace I leave with you, my peace I give to you. Now as the world gives, do I give to you. Let not your heart be troubled, neither let them be afraid. Thank you.
Peace I leave with you, my peace I give you. I do not give to you as the world gives. Do not let your hearts be troubled, and do not be afraid.
Deuteronomy 31:8. It is the Lord who goes before you. He will be with you. He will not leave you or forsake you. Do not fear or be dismayed.
Isaiah 49:13. Sing for joy, O heavens, and exult, O earth. Break forth, O mountains, into singing. For the Lord has comforted his people and will have compassion on his afflicted.
Hi, XCeL. I hope everyone is taking care of themselves and staying very safe. I will be reading to you Psalms 9:9. The Lord is a stronghold for the oppressed, a stronghold in times of trouble, and those who know your name put their trust in you. For you, O Lord, have not forsaken those who seek you. Amen.
Today I'll be reading Psalms 32:7, and it says, you are my hiding place. You shall preserve me from trouble. You shall surround me with songs of deliverance.
Higher, higher.
Our son, Joshua Emmanuel. Today, we are going to be talking from the subject, Jesus is our hope. This is part 3 of a series entitled Jesus Is, and we are elated to get started with this lesson. I don't know about you guys, but in a time that we're living in, when all hope seems to be lost, all hope seems to be gone, it's good to know that we have our Savior, Jesus Christ, who is our hope.
Yeah. Even in the midst of our suffering, guess what? We can still rejoice because we can rely on the presence of God.
Amen. Through our challenges, through our situations, we can rely on His presence. So what does it mean to rejoice? Now, I'm not telling you to rejoice in suffering and every time you get bad news to just celebrate. That's not what we're saying. But it does mean that we can believe that God is doing a redemptive work. God is doing a redemptive work. And here the word redemptive means that God does not waste opportunity, or he does not waste hurt or disappointment. That hurt and that disappointment that you go through and that we all experience at times, he's using it to shape us and to mold us into the image of Jesus, which is his highest passion. That's what God wants ultimately for us anyway, is to be like his son, Jesus Christ.
And when we go through our sufferings, we often sometimes pray and we seek God even more. We may fast, we may come together.
And when we are down to our wits' end, when all resources are gone, when family members are sick, when we lose a loved one, when we can't go and do and maneuver like we used to maneuver and do things like we used to maneuver, that is the type of suffering that pushes us into a purpose,
yeah,
and to a posture of prayer.
Yes.
And it's in these times of suffering that God wants to mold us. This is when God wants to shape us into the person that He wants us to be. But we have to rely on the presence of God.
Even though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil. You are with me. Your rod and your staff, they comfort me.
In Psalm 23 and 4, David writes that he does not fear because God is with him. He relies on God's presence, and it brings him, get this, strength and comfort. Remember that before there is to be a shadow, there has to be light. I don't know what your valley of the shadow of death is, but I do know that the light that is walking with you in the valley. We have hope even in our valley situations. I dare you to tell your neighbor that. Say, we have hope.
We have hope.
In the valley situation.
In the valley situation.
Another song, David reveals that one of the reasons for his joy is that he was forgiven. The Bible says this in Psalms 31 and 1.
Blessed is the one whose transgressions are forgiven, whose sins are covered.
Amen.
This brings us to our second point. We must rely on God's provision.
Amen.
In 2 Corinthians, the 12th chapter, 7th verse, Paul reveals that he has suffered from a thorn in the flesh. God was so concerned about Paul not becoming proud, he allowed this to happen to him to prevent him from becoming conceited. In our current situation, God is saying to us that His grace is sufficient. Let's say it again.
His grace is sufficient.
And even when we're feeling weak, when we're not feeling as strong as we normally are, when we're a little down in our spirit, when our head may be bowed down, guess what? God's grace is still sufficient. And we thank God for His grace.
Amen.
Even in this time, we have to rely on His provision and know that His grace is sufficient. And His grace is not this abstract idea. It is the person of Jesus through the power of the Holy Spirit.
So the hell and the situation that you're experiencing right now, guess what? God's answer for the situation that we're in is His
grace is sufficient.
Yes, it is.
Yes.
And point number three, we know now that we must rely on the presence of God. We must rely on God's provision. And now we must rely on the power of God.
Yes.
I don't know about you, but we need some power.
Yes.
We need to rely on God's power.
Yes.
The Bible says in 2 Corinthians 12, verse 9, it says like this, therefore I will boast even the more gladly of my weakness, so that the power of Christ may rest upon me. What is your weakness today? Maybe it's a son or a daughter who hadn't turned out the way you thought they would turn out. Or maybe it's that job that's gone away. Or perhaps a medical diagnosis that has got you shook up.
Or children, maybe it's just not being obedient to our parents. Maybe it's not loving like we should love each other. And maybe it's not really forgiving like we should. And those may be our weakness, but guess what? So whatever it is, Paul says that we will boast in those things because the power of Christ rests on us.
The greater the enemy, the greater our God is. No matter what it is, the greater the enemy comes at us, the greater Jesus is manifesting His power in our lives. And those of us, some of us hear voices that's telling us to give up, to quit, to let go. I rebuke those voices and I send them back to where they come from, because they don't come from God.
And you will win. You will make it. You will be able to lift your heads up, and you will be able to achieve whatever it is that God has for you, because the power of God rests on us, and His power gives us strength, it gives us hope, and it gives us a future. So we gotta rest knowing that God is with us, and He's with us even during these times. He's still with us. His presence has not left us. He's already lifting us up, and we thank God for being a lifter even at this very moment. So thank you, Lord, for lifting up every person that is hearing us and talking and listening to us right now. We thank God for just lifting us up.
Amen. And so we have, as we get ready to close, we have an assignment that we would like for you guys to do. This week, we want you to write down all the things that you're suffering with or suffering from, and put them in an envelope.
Yes, we have our envelope. And Minister Josh and I, we broke down the things that we are dealing with and things that we want God to help us with. And we got them all in this envelope. And guess what? When you turn it around, we want you to be encouraged that God got this. And He is transforming. So I want you to say to yourself, God got this, and He is transforming me.
Amen. Write that on the outside of your envelope. Write the words, God's got this, and He's transforming me. And so whenever one of those weaknesses come up, you can know that His promise is that He's got it under control.
Yes.
And because God is in control,
there's nothing is out of control. Yes.
Until next time, we love you guys. We're praying that the peace of God that surpasses all understanding will keep your heart and your mind.
Yes.
XCeL,
that's what we do, and that's who we are.